You're still as weak as you ever were. Ha! I've claimed the power that was meant to be mine!
Wingmaster Orchid, or perhaps not. Why have you sought me out? Is it my power you seek? Has your long battle not ended?
No, I have a new battle now. The Black Mage. He foresaw the future and has been manipulating all of us for hundreds of years. The betrayal of the commanders, the surprise attack by those so-called heroes, even being sealed away. All of these setbacks the Black Mage suffered, in truth, he planned them. And Black Heaven was no different. Gellimer betrayed us, I lost my power, and Lotus met his end. The Black Mage was behind all of it, using us for his own gain, and then letting us destroy each other. Lotus is gone because of the Black Mage.
Is it revenge you seek?
I seek his destruction, and I need power to bring him to his end.
Very well. But you must lend this power to the adversary in turn. In the final conflict, they will be the deciding force.
What are you talking about?
You will see. For now, take this and hide your face. As you seek your revenge, others will seek revenge on you. Adversary. The time has come. Only the Black Mage remains. How this battle ends is up to you. It contains the power of the transcendence. You have been chosen to end this. Use your power as the adversary and destroy the labyrinth core.
I told you, I knew they wouldn't have it in them.
We'll be right back.
Your last warning.
Thank you. Thank you. tend to regard fate with a mixture of awe and fear. This is because the future is unpredictable and mysterious for us. True, true. There are a few humans who can see into the future. But they only see fragments, not the full scope. They cannot see the process by which their vision will come to pass. The future is always determined by a singular present. But there are so many moving parts in that present, so many intersections of fate, chance, and free will. Every hand gesture, thoughtless word, and twist of the wind creates and erases uncountable futures. Processing such vast possibilities is beyond any human. It's like a two-dimensional creature gazing into a three-dimensional realm, impossible to even conceive of. With the right process, even the infinite becomes perceptible. Yes. He saw destiny and changed it. Futures were within his grasp, and he made a choice. And that in turn resulted in everything, from Black Heaven to Damien to Aeona. All this time, we've unwittingly danced to his tune. He has led us, tricked us, and manipulated us into producing the future he desired. He has led us on to this path. The path. Oh, we fought of our own free will. It was always our decision. We just didn't know who influenced those decisions. Look here. This is a core fragment from the giant you defeated earlier. Within this fragment are futures that once existed, but were erased by the Black Mage. I have been examining these futures. Across the many timelines, there is one great constant. Those who did the most damage to his grand design were the commanders. Truly accepted his plot was Will. The other commanders rejected the Black Mage's goal. They chose survival. Now, look around you. What's left of them now? Who removed them from the board? Even now, he allowed us to discover this within the beast you defeated. It means our destiny has truly been determined. There's no way that I can see to change fate.
Start. It has haunted me endlessly. I'm sorry. Perhaps I should have told you. But I was afraid you would not come this far if you knew. Listen to me. You are the adversary. But who are you the adversary of? No. The adversary is the adversary of destiny.
you're the one piece on the board the Black Mage does not truly control. That's why he's trying to make you lose hope. Because you are our hope for victory. Prove we are not the puppets of gods. Break these chains of fate.
Empress, we're out of time!
Fight. Win. And come back to us. That's an order. All cannons, fire!
Thank you.
this time? Yeah, of course. But my attacks don't seem to affect him. I can barely make him flinch, and it doesn't seem to last. So it looks like you get to end this thing after all. Can you handle that? Let's go. I'll get my revenge, and you can save your dumb world.
Struggle if you must.
Genesis is about to begin. After that, everything becomes nothing. Listen, when he's weakened, you've got to summon up the power of the adversary and deliver the final blow. Are you really this dense? You failed before because the seal stone only activates off of powerful determination. So get it together and focus. You're the only one who can stop this now. You have to be ready to sacrifice it all, even your life. Good. Then... What? I'm just gonna rest a bit.
No, you did. Just one step, though. You do have the determination to see this through. The world needs you. Everyone is counting on you to stop this. And we don't need someone who's given up. It's time.
Pull the fleet back. The White Spear will proceed alone. I leave the rest to you, Claudine.
Of course, Empress.
All non-combatants, disembark! This is it!
White Spear, full speed ahead! Into the heart of the giant! We shall be the spear that pierces the gods themselves!
How long has it been?
10 minutes since the giant fell silent.
Perhaps we should direct our fire away from the heart.
But you were the one who rejected that idea earlier.
Well, the situation...
Neinhardt, get it together. The soldiers don't need to see you like this.
You're right. Please excuse me.
I'm worried about them too.
Look, over there! Up ahead! Our ship is leaving the giant's heart!
Quickly, covering fire!
All cannons, fire!
It's going to be all right. Relax.
Communications are open. Empress!
We have destroyed the Genesis Crux.
Did you hear that? They did it!
Yeah!
I've been waiting a very long time to meet you, you know. I'm serious. You and I have been locked in this struggle for ages. We have a bond in that. Well, mainly, I want to thank you. You've put an end to something that has gone on for far too long. Immortality becomes a prison once you realize what it entails. I couldn't end this myself, you know. The powers of a transcendent prevent them from ending their existence. Ironic, isn't it? Me. That's right. You see the chaos I wrought over my long existence. People with that kind of power should not exist. And that's why I needed you. We were both bound by destiny. But you were the one who could break those chains. Yours and mine. Now, I have a question for you. Your actions in Esfera, when you refused to take Tana's life, that was the turning point. That was the moment you broke free of the path I had laid out for you. So what I want to know is, why? Why did you make that choice, knowing it would lead to almost certain doom? Sight of the value of life in my pursuit of a perfect world. Without that, my quest could never succeed. And with that, you were able to defeat me. It seems our time together is coming to an end, I'm afraid. Discovered that I had put you on this path, when you began to doubt your free will, what did you feel? And that's just it. If I had given up, you never would have found that strength within you. You've done what I could never do. Never. Forget that strength, and be at peace. She will remember you now. Forgotten hero.
A noble sacrifice, then. I know words aren't enough to express my thanks.
Wait, hold on. I think... Yes, I just saw something else come from the giant's heart!
Cover them!
All cannons, fire!
All cannons, fire!
You've done well. Just as I asked.
The giant is done for!
This isn't the kind of place you'd want to hang around, right? Especially with stupid Claudine glaring at me. Huh? Oh, that... Why? Does that bother you? Yeah, I think I'm about done. Not much left in me anymore. Geez, I might be down to just 100 years or so. What? Did you forget I'm a spirit of darkness or something? Still, 100 years. Maybe living like a human won't be too bad. I said see you around, dummy.
Thank you.